Welcome to Dr. Bernard Harris Senior Elementary School. We are so very excited and honored to have all of you here today. My name is Principal Owens, and we are celebrating 70 of our students who needed glasses. They now have them thanks to Vision for Baltimore. We are so excited about that. Our students not only received one pair of glasses, but they will all receive two pairs of glasses and also monthly support to make sure that they are able to take care of those glasses to ensure that they are able to achieve academic success. Because we know that quite often students are deemed as having deficits when it's really impaired vision. So we are so excited that our students now have glasses. We are also very proud that 100% of our students returned their parent consent forms. Yay! And we could not have done it without the diligent efforts of, is she not here? Our secretary, Ms. Sharon Melvin. She worked very hard with our staff, our parents, our students, and the community to make sure that those things were done. And she's actually celebrating her birthday today. So happy birthday. I told you we would get the mayor and the CEO here for your birthday. We'd also like to thank Christine Santos and Wade Brown because they worked tirelessly with our school to make sure that our students did return those, because without those consents, they could not have gotten their glasses. So we want to celebrate them as well. At this time, I'd like to introduce the Baltimore City Health Commissioner, Dr. Lena Nguyen. Dr. Nguyen is the Commissioner of Baltimore City Health Department. She runs America's oldest and continuously operating health department. She is a practicing ER and a passionate patient and community advocate. So let's welcome Dr. Nguyen.
Thank you very much, Principal Owens, for that very kind welcome and for having us at your school today. So I see a lot of kids today who have these. I wore my glasses today, too, to join you all. Very, very happy to be here with all of you to celebrate a great occasion, which is, for us, the Vision for Baltimore's delivery of the 1,000th pair of glasses. Now, before I introduce my boss, Mayor Catherine Pugh, I wanted to take this opportunity to thank a number of people without whom we would not be here today. You know, our mayor always says, not just once, but she says three times, collaboration, collaboration, collaboration. Because none of this work, I'm channeling Madam Mayor with collaboration. But without the collaboration of so many of our partners in the room, we would not be where we are today. And so I'd like to thank our mayor, Catherine Pugh, for her incredible leadership. I want to acknowledge also our Baltimore City Public Schools CEO, Dr. Sonia Santelises, who you'll hear from later as well. Now, we also have to thank our partners at Johns Hopkins University, led by President Ron Daniels. We also have Dr. Bob Slavin, Megan Collins, and many others at Hopkins who have been instrumental in this. Thank you very much. We've also been working with one of our national nonprofits called Vision to Learn, and representing Chairman and Founder Austin Buettner is Damian Carroll. Thank you very much. Of course, none of this would be possible, too, without the generous support of our funders. And so it's possible that I may be missing some of you in the room, but I see Bob Embry from the Able Foundation. I know Casey Foundation are here, Warby Parker. Thank you so much for your support. Now, I know that often we, as the leaders of our organizations, get the praise and the thanks, but none of this would be possible without our team, without the individuals who make our projects and make our trainings run on time and literally do all the work every single day. And so I would like for everyone to stand up or raise your hand if you're from the Baltimore City Health Department, from city schools, from all of our partners who have been instrumental in this. And I want to call out Gabriel Terry from the Health Department, Francine Childs from the Health Department, Louise Fink from City Schools. Please, if all of you who are involved in any way can please stand and be acknowledged. Thank you. also wish to thank one of our city council members, Councilman Stokes, who is joining us today. Thank you very much, Councilman. And of course, all of our students who are here. You'll hear from our students and our parents in a bit. But, you know, I feel very grateful every day to work for someone who has incredible vision, who exemplifies leadership, and who has an innate ability to bring everyone in the city together around common goals, shared challenges, and to really tackle these hard problems. Again, I feel very fortunate to work for her and today to be able to introduce you to my boss and our mayor, Mayor Catherine Pugh.
So before I get on with the real announcement, Dr. Nguyen, we made a little announcement in one of our meetings yesterday, and the first baby that will be born in my administration is not by me, but by our own Dr. Nguyen. So give her a big round of applause. And we are so proud. We talk about her every day in terms of the work that she's doing. And I can tell you, I've never seen someone work so hard on behalf of the citizens of Baltimore, especially around these health issues. I mean, how exciting is it to be here with our young people to give out the 1,000 pair of eyeglasses? You all look so gorgeous and so handsome. You know, I was greeted by these beautiful students, and I cannot be more excited for you, because here's what we do know. 60% of our population, or 177, listen you all, 177 million, you might know how many people that is, represents, that's a lot of people. 177 million people need some sort of vision correction. In fact, 48% of our parents with children under 12 have never taken their child to a physician or an eye care professional. And that's important, because what we find is that one out of every four children have a vision problem. And as has been said by our principal, is that oftentimes we may think that it's some learning disability, only to learn that it is a vision problem. Doesn't impair them from learning if their glasses are provided for them and their eyes can be corrected. Far too many young people across Baltimore lack access to vision care, and that's what this program is all about. I am so happy that we understand the importance of this. And so as we continue to build our city, to have better schools, to ensure that students have everything they need to be successful, this is one of those great programs that we got to make sure continue to be funded. We are so proud to be able to achieve this through Vision for Baltimore. Since we launched this program, and I say this oftentimes, President Daniels, is that it is the job of the mayor to recognize the great things that are being done in our city and to carry them forward. And so I'm excited that we recognize the importance of this program and carrying it forward for these young people in our city, because we understand that eyeglasses are really an essential tool for those who need it as it relates to learning. It helps to break down the barriers, it helps to create the opportunities, and more importantly for them, it opens their eyes to the rest of the world. And I want to say to my CEO, Dr. Sandalisa, I'm so proud of the work that you are doing, and we're working together. Just for those of you who are out there, and you should know that we're going to fill that budget gap and that we're going to help our school system to be the great school system that it will be. And she and I had a conversation just the other night about the work that we're doing together in Annapolis. And regardless of what people think or believe, you know, when you come into these situations, as she did, as a new CEO, you're confronted with challenges. But what that means is that all hands are on deck, because programs like this have to be sustained. Our children's future have to be sustained. And so as we lift our city up, again, I want to say thank you for the partnership. And more importantly, Dr. Nguyen, thank you for this program. It means a lot to me and to our councilman, Robert Stokes, and to all of the people in our city who want to see our children become the best that they can be. Thank you all. Many of them told me they voted for me as well. Thank you all. I really appreciate you all. So I'm going to turn this back over to Dr. Nguyen.
Thank you very much, Madam Mayor, for your inspiring remarks and for your exceptional leadership. I was in the third grade when I thought that everything was normal. You know, I was squinting to read the board. There were math problems, and I remember there was a map that everybody could see, but I couldn't see. Everything was blurry. And I actually thought that this was normal, right? You don't know that you have an eye problem. You just think maybe everybody else is seeing this at all. And it took me over a year, and my parents over a year, and our teachers over a year to realize that actually what I needed was eye exam and then glasses. Now, I know that I am not alone in this. In fact, our estimates from the health department and from Johns Hopkins show that thousands of elementary school and middle school students in our city lack the glasses that they need. And what ends up happening is that our students will struggle. They could even be put back in school and labeled as being disruptive or having issues when actually what they need is something so simple as a pair of glasses. And so, you know, we are glad to have the evaluation and the studies done by Johns Hopkins, but we all know, I mean, it really is common sense too, that if we can't see, if kids can't see, it's hard to learn. I mean, if I don't have my glasses now, I'm not sure that I certainly would not be safe driving, but I probably would not be so safe walking around either. I'd be running into people all the time. But glasses are important. They are an educational tool. They are a public health tool. And they are really what each of us all need in order to succeed. And so at the Baltimore City Health Department, we believe in going to where people are to provide the services that they need. And so through Vision for Baltimore, we're going to every elementary school and middle school in our city to provide screenings and eye exams and glasses all at school without the child having to miss school and miss their education and without the parent and caregiver having to miss work. And so Vision for Baltimore is about providing every child with glasses, something as simple as glasses, regardless of the ability to pay. It's about leveling the playing field of inequality, and also, as our mayor said, providing an invaluable tool to set up all of our students for success. And so I'm very happy today again to join you all for the delivery of our 1,000th pair of glasses. And again, we could not have done this without the strong support of all of our partners, and in particular from our schools, like Dr. Bernard Harris. I mean, you all have achieved this tremendous return rate of nearly 100%. 100% return rate of consent forms, which means that we're able to provide this critical service to our parents and our children. And so we cannot be more proud of this endeavor. We cannot be more proud of our ability to work together, to collaborate in order to get there. And so I want to thank you all for coming out today and joining us in this collaboration to make Baltimore a healthier, a smarter, and a safer city. I am now pleased to introduce one of our key partners in this effort, someone who I also greatly admire. She has many challenges ahead of her, but she handles everything with aplomb, with grace, and with deep commitment to service. This is Dr. Sonia Santelices, CEO of City Schools.
So I just want to say to everyone, thank you for investing in our young people and our students. It is, and I tell folks this all the time when they say, oh my God, how are you doing? There's so much going on. And I continue to say and believe that there is no better place to be doing this work than in Baltimore City, where we have the leadership coming from the mayor's office, that, you know, a mayor who advocates for young people from day one, has had young people as part of the center of her focus, that is continuing to trickle down and out throughout the administration. I want to say a big shout out also to Lena Nguyen, Dr. Nguyen. I have to be careful because right now she's Lena to me because we can pick up the phone. But Dr. Nguyen's was what I say to a lot of people, my welcome gift when I came. It was my first week in office. And she immediately called me about a grant and a collaboration that yielded millions of dollars worth of support for the young people in this city. And I think this is just another example of her, what I like to call fierce advocacy for the well-roundedness and health of our young people. So I just want to thank her for her continued leadership, President Daniels, and the Hopkins staff, who continue to press themselves to not only be an amazing worldwide institution of higher learning, but their commitment to the vitality of our city is also evident in their partnership like this. And I will say to the young people with their glasses, I want you to know, like Dr. Nguyen, I followed her lead. I, though, always have to wear my glasses because I don't do contacts very well. And I want you to know that I now think I need to get a pair of pink glasses, because that pink is absolutely stunning. So I think I'm going to have to trade in my red and get a pair of pink for special occasions, because you are looking quite dapper in those glasses. So I won't be before you long. Again, I just want to thank everyone. And just to say, this is proof of what happens when, again, as our mayor continues to say, when we collaborate, what we can do. And something as simple as eyeglasses, something that so many of us take for granted, can be such a linchpin for learning. And what I think is interesting about Dr. Nguyen's story is, had she not received glasses in the third grade, she may not have gone on to be the Rhodes Scholar that she eventually was. I was delayed. I had to wait till fourth grade before I coughed up that I couldn't see. But in a very similar story, thought it was normal. And you're absolutely right. And so the fact that there are adults willing to partner together to advocate for our young people, I would just say, young people, you are worth the investment. And now that you have those glasses, you're getting those glasses and you can see, my charge to you is, make sure you read as much as possible. And two, make sure that you open your eyes even further to see the world around you, both what you want to change as well as what you can be and do. Those glasses are the key, are part of the key to you being whatever you want to be. And so I thank you all for being here too. You make the day special. And I just, again, want to just emphasize the importance of what our young people can do when they're given the tools to do that. And again, thank you. And I do have to point out that Principal Owens is a first year principal. And yeah, we should give him. And as a first-year principal, when so many others are just trying to get their head and wits about them, she had 100% return rate. She mobilized staff. She was able to garner that. And I think this is also proof of what school leaders and school staff can do when we really put our minds to it. So kudos also to Principal Owens. And I'll turn it back to Dr. Nguyen.
Thank you very much, Dr. Santelices. You know, when Dr. Santelices mentioned this briefly, but when she first came, I felt rather badly about calling her in her first week, because I'm sure she had many things going on. But there was a grant that we had an opportunity to apply for with a 1 week or a 2 week deadline, something that we had to do immediately. But she saw the importance of it quickly, mobilized her teams, and we got it done. And as a result, have $2.3 million. A $2.3 million grant coming from the Department of Education to our city schools. And that says a lot about her resourcefulness, her energy, and her ability to get things done. So thank you. And another one of our partners who exemplifies action is President Ron Daniels, the president of Johns Hopkins University. Now, I remember this is just over a year ago or so, that we were having a conversation about what is it that we can do for some of these issues in our city. I mean, not everything can be solved overnight. Many of these issues that our mayor tackles require long-term solutions, but might there be some things that we can do together and quickly if we just all work together on it? And we said, all right, there is this issue of glasses, something that's so simple for everyone to understand, but that has such a profound effect. What can we do? And within a matter of weeks, we had launched a fundraising plan. We had organized with our teams on how to get this going, and none of this would be possible without the action orientation and the incredible leadership of our president of Johns Hopkins University, President Ron Daniels.
Well, thank you so much, Dr. Wen and Madam Mayor, Dr. Santelises, so many friends. It's great to be here as we celebrate this 1,000th pair of glasses that are being distributed under this program. It's a really good moment because, as so many of us all recognize, there are things that we can do together that are not that complicated. We just have to show some determination, some will, some imagination, and some impatience, and we can get stuff done in the city. And to be part of this project, and I do want to shout out to my colleagues, McCollins and Bob Slavens, who are here. They could just wave to us because they've been both so important in terms of driving the issues, so important in terms of our ability to drive this program at Hopkins. But for all of us, we just feel so lucky to be part of something that can have a clear impact and an immediate impact that improves the opportunities for our kids. And so before I say something about this program, I just want to say and just switch gears for a second, because we all know there's a broader debate about the future of our city's public school system that's going on outside of these quarters, but has very significant impact on what takes place inside of the school. And I just want to thank you, Madam Mayor, Dr. Santelises, for the leadership that you've played in making sure that we're going to get a budgetary environment together that will allow our school system to thrive. And I say this as an educator, but also as a business leader of the city. We need a great, successful school system that gives every opportunity to our kids. That's important in terms of our ability to recruit people to Baltimore. They are worried about the state of our schools. They want to know their kids, if they come here, are going to go to great schools. And then ultimately, we need great schools because we want to hire people in Baltimore to come and work at Johns Hopkins. There's 55,000 employees at Johns Hopkins. A lot have come out of the Baltimore City school system. And we need more of those students in the years to come. So I just want you to know we support you, and we're so appreciative, Madam Mayor, of your leadership in helping us find the fix. And I do hope that the state will echo and support your efforts in that regard. And again, as a stakeholder, we have very, very significant interest in seeing that happen. Now, very quickly, just on this milestone that is the 1,000th pair of glasses that have been distributed under the program, I want to say something to you guys who are wearing those glasses. And yes, you look really spiffy with them. But more than that, of course, you think of these as a way to improve your vision. And of course it is that. But I like to think of it, and now I'm talking to you as a university president, that this is actually a key also that is just unlocking possibilities for you. And so here I want to say that the glasses are an important complement to your learning. The way in which you take the seriousness with which you take your studies here and how committed you are all important also in terms of unlocking possibilities. But I want you to know that at the end of your time here, and you're thinking about your time at this school, but then there's high school to follow, there's university. And so, not to overwhelm you, but I want you to know that this is one key that you unlock what you do here, and there'll be many other moments when you're going to do that. But when it's time to come to university, here too, Johns Hopkins is really serious about getting you guys to think about us and applying and hopefully come to the institution. And one of the programs of which we're most proud is something called the Baltimore Scholars Program. And university is really expensive, but it turns out for kids who come through Baltimore City Public Schools and who have financial needs, university is free. Like, university is completely free. In fact, it's better than free because under our Baltimore Scholars Program, we'll pay for you to live in our residences and your meal plans and everything. So it's another key for you to unlock possibilities, and just know that as you progress through this program, we're waiting for you, we're counting on you. You are the future of our city, and this is really important for all of us to recognize, to support, and to celebrate in the city of Baltimore is your possibilities and our firm determination that you realize all those possibilities. congratulations on getting your glasses, guys, and I look forward to seeing you on our campus in an average of 8 years time. So we're waiting for you.
Glasses today, Johns Hopkins tomorrow. a lot for us to look forward to. Now, I would like to introduce, before we get to the fun part of talking to our parents and our students and giving our actual 1,000th pair, I would like to introduce someone who has done a lot of work, not only in Baltimore City, but also around the country. So I mentioned earlier Austin Buehner, who is the founder and CEO of Vision to Learn, which is the national nonprofit that we are partnering with. Vision to Learn has done great work in getting together government, nonprofits, foundations around the country to provide services like this. And they are one of our critical partners in this process. And today to represent Austin is Damien Carroll. Damien.
Well, good morning, everybody.
Good morning.
Well, it's a very special day. In addition to giving out our 1,000th pair of glasses in Baltimore today, it is also Wacky Tacky Day. And I see some of the kids who have their great socks on and cool shoes today. You guys want to raise your hands if you're wearing your cool socks? So Wacky Tacky Day is part of Dr. Seuss Literacy Week. And what a perfect time to give glasses to these kids when we are celebrating their ability to read at school, to achieve literacy, and to read all of these terrific books that you see behind me here on the podium. And it's a tremendous thing to have a pair of glasses, and it's the reason that Vision to Learn was started. This month, March, is our 5-year birthday. And I won't make you sing for that. But 5 years ago, Austin Buehner, our founder, reached out to health and educational experts to find out how can we help students at school. And Vision to Learn, since then, has been providing glasses to students all over the country, 176 cities, from Honolulu to Baltimore. We've provided over 73,000 eye exams and over 57,000 pairs of glasses to students free of charge. And we're so proud to be here in Baltimore, a community that has really brought from all sectors come together to help students receive the glasses today. And kids, when you look at your glasses, I want you to think about all the people and all the work that has gone into getting this pair of glasses that you can now put in front of your eyes. The screeners from the health department who came and screened every kid at school. The partners with the school district and Johns Hopkins who made sure that your parents turned in consent forms so that you could get the service. Vision to Learn's clinic that drives right up in front of the school with our optometrists and our optician who give you that great eye exam and help you choose out that perfect pair of glasses. And you have a job now too, right? Yours is the last part of this great chain that brought these glasses to you, because all of these people working together have done this so that you will have a pair of glasses that you can wear at class and see the board and do your math homework and read a book. So when you're at home tonight and you got your glasses, don't put them down at the bottom of your backpack. Think of how special those glasses are and all the people that have helped to bring them to you. Take care of them, make sure to keep them nice and shine, wear them in class as the doctor tells you you should when as they're prescribed. And you're a part of this great experience. All these people coming together, you see all these cameras, they're here to capture what a great thing it is that you're gonna be able to succeed at school because of these glasses. So think about that and really do your job as part of this too. Take care of those glasses and make sure that they're going to the use that we all want them to be. I want to thank a couple of people from Vision to Learn, our Baltimore team. Mr. Wade Brown is our program director. Dr. Fazia Mirza and Dr. Marianne Mai are our optometrists. And Amber Singleton, I think, is here, our optician, who helped get all the glasses fit on the kids this morning. They're doing a tremendous job, and they're a huge part of why we have reached this milestone so successfully and will continue to serve kids all throughout the city. So, and one additional thank you to one of our largest funders in Baltimore, Congressman John Delaney, who supported our program, and of course the Able Foundation. That we wouldn't be here without their tremendous support. So thank you again to everybody, and kids, go out there and conquer the world. Thanks.
Thank you. So it is my pleasure to introduce a parent who had the benefit of having her child receive a pair of these wonderful glasses. And it would be wonderful to have Ms. Honora Goose, who is the parent of sixth grader at Hampstead Hill Academy, who received glasses in the spring of 2016, last year, come up and just share some of her thoughts about what this means from a family perspective. Ms. Goose?
Oh, there you are. Hi, good morning. My name is Honora Goose. My son Adam attends Hampstead Hill. He's in the sixth grade. And before Adam received his glasses, he was complaining that he could not see clearly. But my husband and I both work, and it was very inconvenient to take time to take him to the eye doctor. So when he came home with a letter about the vision testing, we jumped at the opportunity. He was tested, he did receive the glasses, and Adam can see so clearly now that when Adam should be sleeping at night, Adam is up reading his books. So we are very grateful and thankful for the opportunity. Thank you.
Okay, great. So Dr. Nguyen and I are just making sure we're on the same page. I would love to have De'Ara Sellers, a fifth grade student here, come up to receive your pair of glasses. Where's De'Ara? There's De'Ara. Thank you. So De'Ara, I now welcome you to the Club of Four-Eyed Seeing People, and you will do amazing things. Okay?
Very good. Congratulations.
You want to open them up? Hey, did you pick those? Oh, very stylish. You want to put them on? And you're going to look beautiful? Oh, look at that. Oh, dear. And as somebody who taught fifth grade, I will tell you that sometimes being called up in front of a whole lot of people to get something new can be a little difficult to navigate. And De'Ara, you did it with grace, okay? Nicely done. And now I'm going to ask Amira Bailey, another fifth grader here at Dr. Bernard Harris, to come up and share your experiences about receiving the glasses. And is Amira here? Very stylish, Amira.
Good morning. My name is Amira Bailey, and I'm a fifth grader from Dr. Bernard Harris, St. Elementary School, who received two pair of free glasses from the Vision for Baltimore program. My family and I are very grateful for this opportunity of receiving this generous contribution. I have had problems with reading and seeing what has been written on the board. Now, because of this program, I will be able to see better and achieve higher in my academics. I am beyond excited, and I cannot wait to receive my glasses. I know they will add to my style. Again, I just want to say thank you to the Vision for Baltimore. You guys rock!
That was amazing. Let's give her another round of applause. I know that we are very excited to get to join you all today to be with all of our incredible students as they pick out their stylish glasses and show us how cool pink and all the other colors can be. Thank you all for joining us today for this extraordinary event. I now turn things over back to our to our leader in the city, to Madam Mayor, for the rest of your press availability.
Thank you, Madam Mayor. Let me again first say thank you to everyone who had anything to do with this, especially our funders, Dr. Nguyen, and all of your efforts, our CEO, and Ron, I can't thank you enough for all of the things that you do on behalf of the citizens of Baltimore, especially our young people. So you got a whole lot of Johns Hopkins University students standing in front of you. So did you all understand that? You can go to Johns Hopkins University for free. That means getting good grades, reading lots of books. That's what he was saying to you. You can go to Johns Hopkins University for free, but that means good grades, okay? I know you're going to get them, right?
Yeah.
All right. Thank you, everybody. Have a great day. Young people, go pick out your glasses. We're excited for you.
There is a deficit that we must cover to make sure that our teachers are employed, our classrooms have what they need, and we will make sure that that takes place.
What is
Madam
the
Mayor,
largest
what?
Problem with the structural deficit? Is it the pensions? What are you going to chip
well,
away at?
Well, we're chipping away at everything. I'm going to have to go into the city's rainy day fund, as you well know. We have a structural deficit. The state has a structural deficit, and so does the United States of America. It's how you manage your debt that determines your ability to continue to be able to operate and organize.
Madam Mayor, since the federal indictment came down last Wednesday, what changes have the police department made in response to that indictment?
Well, I think you heard today where we sent some police officers back to the patrol, which is very much needed, as you well know. I think I announced last week that we're doing an audit. We've moved the police department's audit up. But, you know, we've got to get a handle on this overtime. $1.6 million every other week is just not tolerable. You know, that's a that creates a $40 million deficit for us as it relates to the police department. So we're working on all of that. We're meeting with the police department. They are reorganizing. And more importantly, we're at the table right now negotiating with the police department as it relates to some of the things that were required, that will be required of the DOJ consent decree. Citizens on trial boards are important. We're asking for two. The DOJ said that that is essential in terms of bringing about the confidence in the community and the community with the police department. That is really important. Also, we're looking at the hours in which they work. And as I mentioned to you all very early, I work 7 days a week. I think most of you all work 5 days a week with 2 days off. Police are 4 and 3. 4 and 3 is for the fire department. Our police officers don't sleep at the various headquarters of the police department. So we need to be able to get our arms around that. We're at negotiations, and I'm looking forward to continuing that.
Madam Mayor,
with video circulating on social media of teens assaulting a man in downtown Baltimore. Have you seen the video?
Obviously not. You're just now showing it to me, but so I have not seen that.
Okay, well, just so you know, police are charging some people, and
so
I wanted to know if you have any idea about it.
You're just showing it to me, so how can I have an idea about
that?
I'll take the next question.
Madam Mayor,
no, I don't.
With body cameras,
yes.
The police say they've cited 109 different instances of police not using their body cameras properly since the program rolled out. What do you think about the supervision of the body camera program? Is it strong enough?
Well, I think we got to get our arms around our body camera laws as it relates to. We've got police officers have them. They need to use them, and we need to put some restraints in place as it relates to how they, you know, some policies in place in terms of how they use them.
The lives of the 6 children, the Malone family fire, we still don't know what the cause is. The Annapolis fire that took the lives of the children and their grandparents a couple of years ago was released. The cause was released much quicker. Are you alarmed at the delay? Do you know what's causing the delay?
I'll ask the fire chief. You know, it is under investigation, as you well know. I mean, it was such a burning fire. I mean, if anybody, as I had gone to the scene there to see what was left, I mean, it was just unbelievable. We don't want anybody in our city dying as a result of fires, and I'm sure all of you all know that. And that's why we put in place making smoke detectors available for free for everybody. And so let me repeat, 311, anybody can get one. You know, our fire department will come out and install them in the houses, in the homes of individuals. And we've got to get everybody in our city understanding that they can help us to save lives of the people in our city. We don't want to see that, but I will ask the fire chief about that.
All right, folks.
Thank you all.